In this video, we'll talk about routing of a user's request, its handling, and generating a response to a user. As you know, Django implements the MVC pattern. The MVC is an acronym to Model View Controller. The main idea of the MVC pattern is that we differentiate code for storing data in a database, this part referred to a model word, from the code for viewing a response to a user, this part referred to a view word, and from the code for routing a user's request, this part referred to a controller word. But Django has some terminology deviation. In Django, for viewing a response to a user are responsible HTML templates, and for routing a user's request, that in traditional MVC pattern referred to a controller word, in Django are responsible urls.py and views.py files. Django is still an MVC framework, but I think it's better to keep in mind these terminology differences. So, if we look at generated files of our blog app, we can match these files to the roles in Django. urls.py files. There is no such in the blog directory, but the urls.py present in the blog engine directory. Views.py files are responsible for handling a user's request, and models.py files are responsible for storing data in a database. Let's begin, and I want to start the Django development server. I'm opening my terminal, and I need a directory that contains manage.py file, and here python manage.py, then run server command, and here I'm specifying the port number explicitly. I want to have 5000 port number. But default Django dev server port number is 8000. So if I run this command now, I will get the dev server on 8000 port number. Django says that there are some unapplied migrations, and to read off this red warning message, I just apply the migrations with the migrate command. And again, that port is already in use. Exception. Okay. Let's look at it in the browser. I'm using Chrome. And when I entered the URL localhost 8000, my Chrome browser generated the GET request to this URL. And in this moment, our task is to receive a user's request, a GET request, and pass it to a function that will handle it. And to do it, I have to open the urls.py file and specify a pattern for a URL address that a user wants to visit. So let's open the urls.py file in the child block engine directory, this one. The block engine directory is the directory with our project's settings, and this urls.py file determines request routing for our entire project. And here we can see the URL patterns variable, that is a list, where each element is a result of the path function. And here I am appending a new URL pattern. Will be the new path function colon. And the path function can receive four arguments. Two arguments are required. These are a URL pattern itself and a function that will handle a request to the URL address and that will match to this URL pattern. And the other two optional arguments are a name of a URL pattern and a dictionary with additional arguments. So I am passing into the path function a URL pattern. Let's say it will be blog as the first argument, and the second argument will be a function that will handle the GET request to this URL, to this one. And that'll be, let's say, will be the hello function. I am saving the urls.py module, and immediately Django says that the name hello is not defined. Okay, let's define it. First of all, to use the hello function in the urls.py file, I have to create it in the urls.py module, or I have to import it from another module. Let's say that the hello function will be created in the views.py module, and I want to import the hello function to the urls.py module. So here, from dot, dot means the current directory, that is the block engine directory, views import hello. That is to say that Python interpreter should import the hello function from the views.py file in the same directory. And in the block engine directory, there is no views.py module. So let's create it. Views.py. And inside the views.py file, I have to define the hello function that will handle a user's request to the localhost 5000 block address. So I have to define it here. Hello request object is the required argument, and it will pass for a while. Now I have the hello function. The handler of the user's request to the block URL, and let's make a new GET request to that address. /blog. Great. Django raises the exception that the hello function didn't return an HTTP response object, it returned noun instead. And this is absolutely right, because our hello function is empty now, but this exception doesn't really matter. But what matters here? My request to this address was routed via urls.py file and then passed into the hello function. When I entered the URL to the address bar of my Chrome browser, the Chrome generated the GET request that was routed to the urls.py module, this one. From the urls.py module, Django gets the information that all requests to the blog address are handled by the hello function that was imported from the views.py file, this function. And so let's look at the request object that our hello function takes as an argument. The request object is a global object that is accessible in our entire project. So let's here will be an empty string, print request, empty string again. I want to see attributes of the request object, and again an empty string. And now to see the results, I have to call the hello function again. That is, I have to go to the localhost 5000 block address and make a request again. I got an exception again, but it really doesn't matter now again. We can see the request object and HTTP method. It was the GET request to the blog URL. And these are the attributes of the request object. Some of them we will use a bit later. But now it's time to return to a user an HTTP response object as Django wanted from us. So here, from Django HTTP module, import HTTP response. And let's say the hello function will return HTTP response instance. And again, I am opening the blog URL. And now we can see the hello world header. Okay, it's working, but in the last video I created the blog application that I have to use for encapsulation of a data and a logic of my app. Let's plug in it into our Django project. I have to open the settings.py file and I have to append the name of my blog app to the installed app list blog. Okay, and now I have to reroute a user's request to my blog application. And to do it, I have to open the urls.py file, this one, in the blog engine directory. And instead of the hello function as a handler of a user's request in the path function colon, I have to tell Django that all requests to the blog URL should be rerouted to the blog app to its urls.py file. To do it, I have to use the include function from the Django urls module. So here from Django urls import include. And so instead of the hello function, I'm calling the include function, and as an argument I'm specifying the path to the urls.py file. Blog is my app and urls is the module that will route all user requests to the blog address. And we can see that in the blog directory there is no any urls.py module, so let's create it. And here I have to reproduce all content from main urls.py file. Let's copy this and paste it here. I am deleting admin, deleting include, also this one, and admin. URL pattern will be an empty string, and the handler function will be, let's say, index function that I want to import from the views module, from .views import index. Then I am opening the views.py file, and here I have to define the index function that will accept the request object as an argument. Then I'm importing from Django HTTP response class, and the index function will return HTTP response instance with the same content. Hello world. Hello world from blog index. And again, no module named blog urls. It's weird, but I think that the Django doesn't know that the blog app was included to the installed apps list. So I think that I have to restart the server. And it works. And it means that my request to the localhost blog page was routed to the urls.py file of the blog app and was handled in the views.py file by by the index function. Okay, how does Django perform a routing of requests? Let's assume that a user opened some domain. Blog, some post URL. Django cuts off the domain name and the rest of the URL address, this part. Django looks for matching of this part of the address to a pattern in the URL's pattern list. And Django will find the blog pattern, and all requests to it should be routed to the urls.py file in the blog app. Django cuts off matched part of the URL address again, this part, and sends the rest to the urls.py file in the blog app, here. The urls.py file in the blog app has no URL pattern for some post address. So, if I'll try to open this URL, I'll get an exception. I opened just the main blog address. And the first time Django cuts off the domain name, and at the second time, Django cuts off the blog part, this one. So in this case, the empty string is in the rest that was passed to the urls.py file of the blog app. And that's all with the basics of routing. In the next video, we will use HTML templates and look at template inheritance.